In this video series, I'm going to show you how to paint a Militarum Tempestus Taurox Prime, and I'm going to be focusing mainly on how to dry brush the hull and also how to use masking tape to get nice neat markings on the model. Now, there are some areas on the model that are painted in exactly the same way as on a Tempest or Scion, so if you've not seen our video series on painting that yet, I recommend you do so first. But when I get to those areas, I will point them out to you. So let's get started. So I've undercoated the model with Chaos Black spray, and something I want to point out to you before we start painting is that I've actually left the bull bars off on the miniature, so that's so that later on I can get to all this detail on here. But the first thing we need to paint onto the model is a good solid blue, and the ideal colour for this is the fang. So as always, got to give the paint a good shake, and the brush I'm going to be using is a large dry brush, and this is simply because there's so much of this colour to paint on at this stage. Now what I like to do is pop the paint on the palette like this, because this will help control how much paint I've got on the brush. Because, well, I don't want too much in the bristles, because then it's very easy to start clogging up detail. Now this is very simple. All you got to do is just start painting it onto the model like this, making sure you work it into all the little nooks and crannies and little recesses on the armour like this. So just take your time and work across the whole model. Now you might find that some of the paint is still a bit see-through and you can still see the undercoat through it, and that's absolutely fine. Just paint another layer on once that layer's dry. Always remember, multiple thin layers are better than one thick layer. Now also, you might find that, if you need to water the paint down, if you use the large dry brush, it's quite difficult to control how much water you're adding to the paint, because it absorbs water very quickly, you see. So it's a good idea to have a large brush on hand that you can switch to instead for doing that. So I'm going to do this colour on the whole model now, and also on the turret. Now that I've finished my base coat of the fang, I'm ready to move on to the first layer paint, and that's going to be Thunderhawk Blue, and I'm going to be applying this in essentially the same way as I did with the fang. And well, I have had people asking me then what the point is in painting it the fang in the first place, and that's the same as, well, with any layer and base paint really. If you're going to be applying a layer paint, it's always best to put down a base paint first, because then your colour will be much richer and much stronger. So it's just a case now of painting this on in exactly the same way. So I'm going to cover all of the blue over the whole model, and just like before, got to keep an eye on it just to make sure I'm not clogging up any detail. Now I've finished applying the Thunderhawk Blue, you can see what I mean. By applying that base paint first, I've now got a really strong, rich colour. And the next thing I'm going to do is apply a shade to it. And the shade is Reichlin Flesh Shade, and I'm going to be using a detail brush, because this part is quite precise. So as normal, I'm going to be using my palette. Get a good blob of paint on there. And you don't need loads on your brush. About that should be fine. And what you do is, on all the areas that are going to stay blue, you've got to work around the model, painting this colour into all the recessed panel lines like this. Now this will take some time to do, but the results are absolutely worth it, because this makes all the shapes and features of the model really start to stand out. So just take your time working around the model, and as you can see, I'm being as neat as possible. And whilst you're at it, don't forget to do it around the rivets as well. There, so I finished applying the shade to the model, and you can see it's really made all that detail start to pop out at you. The next stage in the model is to apply a dry brush to it, and the colour I'm going to use is Thunderhawk Blue, which is a layer paint rather than a dry paint, but the technique to apply it is exactly the same. Now you also might be wondering why exactly we're painting it Thunderhawk Blue again, seeing as we've already done it once. But the reason is, when I give this a dry brush of this colour, it's going to neaten up all of that shading that we've just done. Okay? Now the brush I'm going to use is the large dry brush that I used originally, and I've made sure it's completely bone dry before moving on to this stage. Now it's very important that you do that, because if you don't, it can leave a bit of a streaky mess on the model. Okay, so when it's completely dry, what you do is just get a bit of paint on the tip of your brush like that, and just start working it into some tissue like this, which will work the paint in amongst all the bristles and get rid of any excess that you don't need. So you can test on the tissue like that to see what kind of amount of paint it's leaving, and that's about right. So you're looking for your brush to look something like that. Now what you do is grab your model and start flicking this colour back and forth over it like this. Now as I say, the effect is subtle, but what this does is neaten up all of that shade we applied earlier. Now notice how heavy I'm being with this, how rough I am with how I'm flicking it back and forth. Just work your way around the whole model like this, and then we'll be ready to add some highlights to it. Now I finished in the dry brush on the model, and you can see, like I said, the effect is subtle, but it's neatened up all of that shading for us. And now we're going to do another dry brush on the model, and this one is going to highlight it. Now the colour this time is Fenrisian Grey, and we're going to be applying it in much the same manner. So like before, a little bit on the brush, and start working it into the tissue. A bit more, like that. So we're working it in amongst all the bristles. Now you really don't need very much on the brush this time, okay? So it's a good idea to check it on the tissue before you, yeah, that's good. So you don't need very much at all. So check on the tissue before you start dry brushing it on the model. And it's the same kind of technique, but be very gentle with it this time. Just lightly start flicking it across the model, angling your brush as best you can towards those edges like that. And well, you can see the effect already as that paint starts catching on all those corners and picking them out. You see, it looks great. It's very easy doing this, and in fact, this technique works really well on any vehicle that has nice sharp edges like this. So what I'm going to do now is just work my way across the whole model, and then it's nicely highlighted. There, so with that dry brush finished, you can see a huge amount of this model is now complete. And that dry brush has really brought out all of those details. So, in the next video, I'm going to be showing you how to use masking tape to paint on all the cool markings on the vehicle, and also, I'm going to show you how to paint all the details on it too. So, I'll see you in part 2.